Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Dear student, how are you? I hope you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am also fine. I am Muhammad Mujahidul Islam, English teacher of Satyantala Suramankati High School. Dear student, today I am going to discuss about voice. Voice is the most important part in English grammar because voice gives us a clear concept of verb. If we do not understand voice, so we will mistake who has done the work. So we need to learn voice. So, dear student, learn voice or you will be mistaken. Then, let's get started. Welcome to my class. At first, we will learn what is voice. Voice is the form of verb. Voice is the form of verb, which indicates where the subject does the work or something has been done to it. Or you can also say whether the subject performs the action of verb or it does not perform the action of verb by which we understand it. It is called voice. For example, dear student, look at the sentence. I read my textbooks attentively. In this sentence, I subject and read verb. The action of verb is done by the subject I, so it is a voice. Another example. Suggestion has been given by my teacher. Dear student, this sentence subject suggestion, but in this sentence subject suggestion has not done the work. So it is also a voice. Dear student, now we will learn types of voice. Types of voice. How many types of voice? There are two types of voice. There are two types of voice: active voice and passive voice. So, dear student, we have learned about what is voice, what is voice, types of voice. There are two types of voice: active voice and passive voice. Now we will learn what is active voice or how is the sentence of active voice. We also learn what is passive voice and how is the sentence of passive voice. So, dear student, let us go to start. What is active voice? Active voice. Active voice means when the subject does the work of the sentence is called active voice. When the subject performs the action of verb, it is called active voice. Dear student, look at the scene. What do you see? In the scene, you see that a girl and she is subject. A girl is praying. A girl is praying. You see that a girl is praying. Subject, the girl. Subject, the girl, and her is praying. The work has been doing by the subject, has been done by the subject. So it is active voice, because in the sentence subject the girl and the subject performs the action of verb. So it is called active voice. Now we learn about what is passive voice. Passive voice, when the subject does not do the work, rather something has been done to it, it is called passive voice. When the subject does not do the work, when the subject does not perform the action of verb, rather something has been done upon it by other, it is called passive voice. Dear student, look at the scene. What do you see? There is a flower. Now the flower is subject, verb is liked. Flower subject is liked. In this sentence the subject flower is not performs the action of verb, rather like verb is performed by other. So this is passive voice. The sentence is a passive voice because flower is liked by everybody. Flower subject, in this sentence the subject does not perform the action of verb, so it is passive voice. Dear student, then we have learned what is active voice, what is passive voice. Now we will learn about how to change active to passive. Now we will learn how to change active to passive. But dear student, to change active to passive, at first you need to do two words. You do not start to change the voice without doing this work. At first you identify the tense of the sentence. Secondly, find out object of the sentence. When you will go to change active to passive, firstly you identify the tense of the sentence and find out object of the sentence. Though it is not a rule of changing voice, but you need to do it. Without doing this work you will be mistake. So when you go to change active to passive, at first you will identify the tense of the sentence and find out object of the sentence. Now you may have a question, how you will get object? How will get object? So dear student, look at the note. To find out object, ask to her with what and whom. If you want to take object from the sentence, so you must ask to her with what or with whom. For example, dear student, look at the board. This is my board. I give you a sentence to clear your concept about find out object. So dear student, look at the sentence. I bought a book from book fair. I bought a book from book fair. So dear student, at first we do not start to sense voice the sentence without doing these two work. At first you identify the tense of the sentence. What tense the sentence is? You see that I bought subject verb past form. So it indicates past indefinite tense. The sentence is past indefinite tense. Next, you must find out what is the object in the sentence. So dear student, how can you get object? Asks to verb. What is verb? What? What? Verb. So asks to bought verb. What I bought. Asks what bought. What I bought. So you get a answer. The answer is a book. I bought a book. Again, you asked what I bought. The answer will be I bought a book. A book. So a book is object. Dear student, if you do not understand, so I will give you another sentence. Can I clear it? Clear. Look at the next sentence. The whole world honors our freedom fighters. At first, we identify the tense of the sentence. The whole world honors. Subject, verb, is or is. So it indicates present indefinite tense. Now we identify the tense of the sentence is present indefinite tense. Now we will find out who is object in the sentence. So dear student, how can I get object? To find out object, ask to verb. What is verb? Verb is honors. Honors. Ask to honors. Whom honors? The whole world whom honors? You will get an answer. Whole world honors whom? Our freedom fighter. So our freedom fighter is object in the sentence. Dear student, if you want to sense active to passive, you must do this work at first, because without doing this work you may be mistake. Now we will learn about the rule of changing voice active to passive. So dear student, look at this rule of changing active to passive. There are some rule one by one. If you want to change active to passive, so you must follow the rules. The rule is, first, number one, object will be subject. That means the subject of object will be subject. Sorry, object will be subject. The object of active voice take subject in passive voice. Number two, auxiliary verb according to tense and subject. Number two will be auxiliary verb. Number three, verb past participle. That means main verb will be past participle. Number four, extension if they present. extension there will be not always if they present, so you take it after verb. Number 5, preposition by, at, with, to, etc., maybe. Most of the case, most of the verb takes by, but there are some verb which do not take by. In this case, there may be at, with, to, etc. Number six will be subject, will be object. That means the subject of active voice will be object in passive voice. So dear student, if you want to change active to passive, you must follow the rule one by one. There are six work. Number one, object will be subject. Number two, auxiliary verb according to tense and subject. Number three, verb past participle extension if they are present, they may be or not may be. Number five, preposition by, most in the case preposition by, but there are some in case there may not be by, there will be at, with, to, etc. Number six, subject will be object. So dear student, you must memorize this rule to change active to passive. Now we make a sentence for practice. Look at the board. This is my board. This is my board. Dear student, look at the sentence. I bought a book from book fair. I bought a book from book fair. Do you start to change active to passive? No, you do not start active to passive. Remember, at first you need to do two words. At first, identify which tense the sentence is. Which tense the sentence is? I bought a book. You see that the sentence is past indefinite tense. Next, find out who is object in the sentence. So dear student, how can I get an object? Ask to verb bought. What I bought? A book. So dear student, you see that the sentence is past indefinite tense and a book is object. Now we can start to change active to passive. So dear student, to change active to passive, at first object will be subject. Object a book will be subject. A book. Number two, auxiliary verb according to tense and subject. Auxiliary verb, past indefinite tense auxiliary verb was where? A book, third person singular. So the auxiliary verb will be was. Number three, verb past participle. Verb bought. Past participle form also bought. Number four, extension if there. You see that there is extension from book. So it will be here, extension. Number five, preposition by. Number six, subject I will be object. Subject I, it's object from me. So dear student, it is the process of changing active to passive. At first, object a book will be subject. Past indefinite tense, so auxiliary verb was. Verb bought, Bhitri bought. From book fair, extension. Number 5, preposition by. Number 6, I subject, object from me. So dear student, I will also give you another sentence to clear your concept. So clear it. There is also another subject. Read the sentence. We love our country. At first, we identify what tense the sentence is. We love our country. You see that the sentence is present indefinite tense. Now we will find out object. So dear student, to find out object, ask to verb love. Whom we love. The answer, we love our country. Whom we love? Our country. So our country, object. The sentence is present indefinite tense and object our country. So dear student, now we can start to sense active to passive. At first, object will be subject. Object our country will be subject. Number 2, auxiliary verb according to tense and subject. Tense present indefinite tense auxiliary verb am is are. Our country third person singular, so it takes is. Number 3, verb past participle. Verb love, participle love. Number 4, extension if they present. You see that there is no extension, so you do not need it. Number 5, preposition by. Number 6, subject will be object. Subject we, it's object from us. So dear student, if you want to sense active to passive, you must follow the rule. Dear student, you see that in number 2 auxiliary verb according to tense, auxiliary verb is tense has separate auxiliary verb. So dear student, now we will learn what they are. Auxiliary verb according to the name of tense. Auxiliary verb according to the name of tense. Auxiliary verb according to the name of tense. Dear student, look at the chart. First column, name of tense. That means in this column, there will be use name of tense. Second column, name of auxiliary verb. In this column, there used name of auxiliary verb according to tense. Number 3, form of main verb. So dear student, look at the table. At first, present indefinite tense, auxiliary verb am, is, are. Form of main verb, past participle. Present indefinite tense, auxiliary verb am, is, are. Present continuous tense, auxiliary verb am being, is being, are being. Am, is, are plus being. That means am being, is being, are being. Main verb form, past participle. Then past present perfect, auxiliary verb have been, has been, main verb past participle. Past indefinite tense, auxiliary verb was a, main verb past participle. Next, past continuous tense, auxiliary verb was being, were being, main verb, past participle. Past perfect tense, auxiliary verb, had been, main verb, past participle. Main verb, past participle, past, sorry, future indefinite tense, auxiliary verb, shall be, will be, main verb, past participle, future continuous tense, auxiliary verb, shall be, will be, being, that means shall be, being, will be, being, main verb, past participle, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, auxiliary verb, shall have, will have, plus been, that means shall have been, will have been, verb, past participle. So dear student, if you want to change active to passive, you must memorize this chart. But look again, present indefinite tense, am, is, are, present continuous tense, am being, is being, are being, present perfect tense, have been, has been, past indefinite tense, was, are, past continuous tense, was being, were being, past perfect tense, had been, future indefinite tense, shall be, will be, future continuous tense, shall be, being, will be, being, future perfect, shall have, will have, been. So dear student, now I will give you homework. Your homework will be, you see that there are some sentence, change this sentence active to passive. It is your homework, you must do it in your home. So dear student, no more today. We meet again on the next class. We will learn how to change active to passive of the negative sentence and interrogative sentence. We also learn when subject and object form will be changed and when it does not change. Dear student, I pray to Allah. May Allah make you a good man. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye.